Welcome to Dhyeya Coaching Academy presents Career Guidance Series, The Journey Towards My Dhyeya. Today we have with us another young entrepreneur, young physiotherapist, Dr. Kreena Gandhi. Welcome, Kreena. How are you?
Hello. So glad. I'm really happy to be on this platform. Thank you so much for inviting me.
First of all, congratulations, new mother. So she's a mother to a cute little 11-month-old baby girl. So how do you manage all this together?
It's overwhelming at times, but I try and I manage my professional and personal life together. And maybe it's because it's more overwhelming because of the situation right now. It's COVID and it's pandemic and she's too young. But as a health worker, I always feel that, you know, I have my patients to serve. So yes, I'm taking extra precautions. I have to stay away from her for a while until, I'm all taken bath and I've done everything. But yes, it's good. The moment I come enter the house, the smile that I get when the way she looks at me, it's really, it surpasses all my tiredness. So I'm really happy.
And she's really sweet. She's an angel. She's really sweet.
Thank you. Thank you so much.
And Dr. Kreena, thank you so much. Right now, at this peak time of responsibility that you're facing, you still could spare some time for us for this interview today. Yes. Thank you so much for it. Dr. Kreena
anything
Gandhi,
for you because
yes
anything for you because I have known the way you have started this, and I'm really happy with your academy, and students feedback also that you are posting, and it's actually very nice you have started this field. And it's really good because nowadays people are confused to go in which field because the education system is changing, and they don't know. 10th standards exam has cancelled, the admission process has changed. So people, the students especially and parents, are really in dilemma. So I'm really happy that you have started this, and people can follow and they can know like what are the choices that they can make in their life ahead.
Definitely Dr. Kreena Gandhi, she's the owner of Cure Physio Clinic, FC Road, Pune, and head physiotherapist at Prime Physio Clinic. She's also certified in sports injury, pre and post natal care, women's health, and core fitness. Do you specialize basically in all of these fields? And what led you what motivated you into physiotherapy?
Yeah, so I had pursued my 10th. After that, I did my 12th. And after 12th, my cousin sister, she is a physiotherapist. And she is in Chicago right now and doing really well in her career. So I never wanted to be in science. I always thought that I'll do something in arts or commerce. But I used to be with my sister, and she told me that this is not... Because I thought that there would be a lot of studies, and you have to study a lot like MBBS, and I was not that focused in my 12th standard. I thought, maybe I'll go and do some simple courses. But then she told me that, this field of physiotherapy is really, it will change your perspective towards life, you will come to know. Like it's a different science. So, you just try. And I had seen her treating also when I had visited her college also. So I had some idea about physiotherapy. I was very glad that I had someone from my family to guide me and, to take up this field. So yes, I took up physiotherapy then. I took the admission, and all the courses that I have mentioned, yes, you need certification for those. There are many courses available in and around in your city. You can apply for them. And, there are expert doctors and retired professors who are taking up and, conducting such courses for all the young physiotherapists so that, they get an add-on star on their resume. And it's something, it's an add-on treatment that you can do, it's a service that you can learn and you can treat those patients. So
absolutely. What is the basic exam structure for this physiotherapy field?
Okay, so I think right now, when it was my time when I had done it, I think currently right now also it's the same pattern. You have to give your 10, then you have to give your 12, but for your 12 it's very important that you have physics, chemistry, and biology. So that biology is required. And after 12th, you have certain entrance exams. So there is CET, I think now there is some NEET exam also, right, which you have to give. Yeah, but as far as I am aware, you do NEET is not compulsory to give. There are certain exams like affiliated CETs also private colleges that they hold. Like for example, DY Patil, they have their own entrance exam. Then my college, Pravara, they have their own entrance exam. So there are private CETs also. If you, it's just that you have to research that which colleges are good of physiotherapy, and you can apply for those entrance exams separately.
Okay.
Also, I think the criteria is that in 12th standard, you at least need your percentage should be more than 60%. Then you are eligible to apply for the entrance test. So I think that's the scenario. That's the way it process.
And what was your experience in starting your own clinic? You were working, or I guess you're presently also working somewhere else, plus you're handling your own clinic.
Yes.
So how do you manage with this, and what motivated you to start?
I think physiotherapy is such a field because it's a hands-on technique, and it's more on how the way you treat and how the way you give stretches. Mm-hmm. So once you gain experience after passing out, it's a 4.5-year course, physiotherapy. Okay. Mm-hmm. So once you are done with your 4.5-year course, you have internship. Once you are done with your internship, either you can go for master's, you can apply in abroad also for master's. So I think it's not like dental where you have to repeat the whole graduation. For physiotherapy, you can directly apply in abroad for master's based on your graduation marks currently. So in abroad, you can apply for master's. In India also, you can apply for master's. It's a 2 years course. Once you're done with that, I think I would suggest everyone to, you know, gain a lot of experience by joining hospitals, private clinics, working under some physiotherapists, because that really helped me. Because you have so many techniques, you have so many manual therapy and different modalities. One clinic has the latest technique while others are still following the traditional methods. So you get explored, you know, you can explore so many things. So I think I took experience for 5 years. I worked in Mumbai also at Nanavati Hospital. I was working in a private clinic in Grand Road. So side by side, I had a habit of working, you know, from hospital to clinic, clinic to hospital. Plus, the best part is that you get home visits, because there are elderly patients, there are stroke patients who have paralysis. They can't travel to clinic. So this different sector of home visits are also available for physiotherapists. So I think I had started doing that also in Mumbai. So all these experiences gave me confidence, because from the word of mouth, from patients, you know, I used to get it, yeah, bahut acha treat kar rahe ho, aapka treatment acha hai, hum theek ho gaye. So this all motivated me to open my own clinic, and here I am, that I have my own clinic, and still, I mean, touch wood, I hope that I am able to serve everyone the way I have been doing it.
And you are already such a charming personality, I'm sure you're going to get many more patients.
Thank you so much.
As a girl, it is really difficult for us to manage career as well as house. We all have this experience. So how did you manage with this? Was it difficult coping up with everything? Like as a single, before marriage, it is different. After marriage, it is different. You're still working with a kid. So how is the experience?
I think, of course, be it anything, it's difficult for a girl, for a woman. And I think I remember Anand Mahendra, the owner, he had posted a tweet, you know, where a female and a guy, they are, you know, on a running track. And, you know, it's on a mark, get set, go. But a female, a woman has to actually cross all the household hurdles. And then she, you know, starts running the race. I think you also must have seen that post. And I really liked that post a lot. And I believe in it so much, because be it, you know, even, I won't say like on your husband or your family, they are 100% supportive or they are not supportive. For me, I'm lucky that they are supportive. But even if you have their support, it's you who have to manage everything, and it's you who have to take the decision, you know. So you are the one who has to manage accordingly. So it's always, it's going to be difficult for women, but I think that's our superpower. I think that's what we are made for. So I don't think that there is nothing that we can't achieve. And I think we are the only one who can manage both the things. So I am really happy that I am one of those women who is managing the personal and professional life together.
Absolutely. How has this COVID situation affected physiotherapy as a field today?
So there are patients, but patients are very skeptical, because we have you know, there are like patients are divided into emergency cases and normal, you know, pain patients. So some of the patients, there is a slack right now in all the job sectors because of the COVID pandemic. I won't say that my clinic is flourishing right now. It's not, because people are so scared to step out of their house. Right. Even if it's a back pain or a neck pain, you know, they do like, ma'am, up online consultation, they know, and you know, I try to guide them online. What remedies or what things at home they can do, and certain exercises that I can give them online. And you know, they are trying to manage with this right now, you know, staying home and managing through online consultation. Rest who are emergency patients who have a fracture, who are, you know, into strokes, they are still, you know, coming with a lot of risk to clinic. And I am treating those patients at my clinic. So yes, it has affected my clinic as well. But yes, I am trying to serve them via online consultation and via online treatment as much as I can. Yeah.
Yes, doctors are really superheroes today. We thank you all so much for this. Truly. Students nowadays have this laid back attitude. Like you said, the exams have been postponed or canceled. They do not know what to do. They're all this lethargic, only on their phones, playing games and social media. So what would you do to encourage such a student, or what would you, how would you guide them? Ki proper career path pe aane ke liye, unhone abhi kya karna chahiye in this
Correct. For the students actually who are laid back, I think I would just tell them ki thoda vision banao. अगर आप टाइम पास कर रहे हो, अगर आप इंस्टाग्राम पे रील भी देख रहे हो, अगर आपका कुछ करियर ओरिएंटेशन नहीं है, तो एक रील भी बनाने के लिए मेहनत लगती है. यू नीड वीडियो एडिटिंग, यू शुड हैव दैट नॉलेज की एडिटिंग कैसे करना चाहिए, यू शुड हैव दैट नॉलेज की कैमरा एंगल कैसा होना चाहिए. मतलब एक छोटा सा एग्जाम्पल है दैट नथिंग इज ईजी इन लाइफ. इफ यू वॉन्ट टू जस्ट प्ले गेम्स ऑल्सो, यू शुड हैव दैट ब्रेन टू क्रॉस द लेवल, राइट? सो माइट एज वेल यू पे अटेंशन टुवर्ड्स योर करियर, एंड यू नो द मोर यू लर्न फ्रॉम योर सराउंडिंग, द मोर knowledge you gain, that's really going to help you. So ye abhi time hai ki you are getting so much time to think that what you want to do in your life. So make sure that, you know, khelo, time pass karo, but you know, also pay some amount of time to focus on your life ki aage kya karna hai. So I think the platform that you have started, you know, and people can Google, people can follow you, and you know, they can get those guidance ki okay, is this field interesting for me? Thoda research karo uske upar Google pe. And you know, ask everyone from your family also ki kiske paas kya experience hai, and then you know, you should take, you should go step by step, you know, to follow this. Because the pandemic is not going to end, and the pandemic is like, you know, the conditions are just going to worsen. But yeah, we are hoping for a brighter side where, you know, people are actually not dying and, you know, getting cured. So if, I think the in future, like right now, students have started coding, you know, for school children, coding has started for school children's, I think people who are going into medical services in future, this all things are going to require. Like I never had coding in my life. Like you teach me right now, ki kuch, seriously. So I think you should go with the trend. I would just tell all the young people ki jo trend mein hai, jo courses chal rahe hai, jo nahi nahi fields aa rahi hai, just look into it. And you know, digital marketing, I never had all these things.
Right.
Social media platforms. So all these are new fields. Physiotherapy also, because physiotherapy right now, COVID patients, you know, we are breathing technique, proning techniques, all these techniques are coming into limelight. So we are treating now. People never used to pay attention to breathing. Hota ye bahut boring hai, ye bahut slow hai. Yoga mein hi karte hai. But right now, if you know, if you don't know a proper breathing technique and you feel breathlessness, then you need to know lung expansion. So I think every field is interesting. It's just you should have your you should just find your niche and then you should go for it.
Absolutely. As a physiotherapy student in college as well as during your internship, did you face any pressures or any obstacles, maybe from your classmates, peer pressures, or from your seniors? Have you faced any of such things?
I have faced everything because I was in hostel life. So yes, we had a hostel life. Yeah, so we had this senior pressure. When it came into academics, yes, there were competitions. I think in every field, there is a lot of politics. There were days when, you know, people used to not share notes, you know, like they used to attend those lectures and my other classmates, like there was rivalry, there was competition to come first and all those things. But I think that's life. And that's an experience that you gain, and it helps mm-hmm. you to build up your confidence, and you come to know what your character is. So mm-hmm. I think right now I can say that it helped me, but that time, no, I had to face so many things, but there were good memories also. So academy-wise, the subjects are every year, you know, the studies, they keep on increasing. It becomes, mm-hmm. the difficulty level increases. But once you reach fourth year, you're mm-hmm. so happy, because in fourth year, third year, you know, from third year, you start seeing patients, you know, they give you ward mm-hmm. postings. So I had been posted to gynec ward also, gynecology. So I myself have seen two deliveries in that time. I had seen cesarean, I had seen normal mm-hmm. delivery. So you start getting that feeling of doctor, you know, in yourself mm-hmm. that, okay, this is because someone is going to be under your hands, okay? Like mm-hmm. Once the delivery is done, you have to help the mother to get up and walk. So yeah. It's a different feeling, and it's a different... I think enjoyment, and it's, you have a different zeal to continue studying. So, and it's really good. It's a nice field, and I really enjoyed my hostel life. I really enjoyed all my studies also. Mm-hmm. I think by first and second year, I was not that good in my studies. Mm-hmm. But third year, yes, when I started getting medicine subjects and surgery, mm-hmm. gynec, that's when I picked up, and I'm really happy that I completed everything.
Like you said, traditional physiotherapy and today physiotherapy is, yeah. there's a huge difference between it. So students ko aise lagta hai ki is field mein paisa hai kya, zyada kama sakte hai kya, related to the other doctor medical fields. So isme hai kya, ya opportunities pe, can you please elaborate a little more ki isme paisa kitna kama sakte hai?
So see, money actually, physiotherapy ek service industry hai. So city, say, you know, from it depends from city to city, hospital to hospital. अगर आप private hospital में काम करते हो तो आपका salary ज़्यादा होगा. अगर आप government में करते हो तो काम ज़्यादा होगा, पैसे कम होंगे. और clinic में काम करोगे तो of course I would just say कि starting, I guess it starts from 7,000 for a intern. That's what I would say. But then it can reach to lakhs also, 50,000 also. It's on you how you build. अगर आप home visit लेते हो, आप जितने home visit करोगे दिन में, आप दिन का उतना कमाओगे. It's like that, because आपका ही उतना marketing होगा, आपका ही उतना word of mouth होगा, patient ही उनके family में फिर आपको refer करेंगे, उसी तरह आप contacts बना के, you know, you can earn. ऐसा नहीं है, people always say कि abroad में physiotherapy को ज़्यादा मिलता है, which is true. If you go to abroad, your payment actually starts with 60,000 or 1 lakh per month. That is a huge difference from abroad to India. That's why many physiotherapists, you know, they go to abroad. But I would say, stick to your ground. If you are in India, it's nothing like that. It's just ki aisa abroad mein hi paisa hai, aisa abhi aisa kuch nahi hai. Right now, even with home visits, with clinic, with your own setup, you can earn the same amount. You know, you'll have to work hard, but yes, you can.
Okay. Definitely.
So paisa hai, par mehnat bhi hai. It's like that.
Right. And coming to your reels, you have done wonderful reels in social media. So how is it? Like, how is the experience in social media coming to the reels part of it?
Yes, it was very new to me. And I remember jab TikTok tha, that was, I had everyone teasing me ki tu to TikTok wali hai, TikTok walo ko kuch kaam dhanda nahi rehta. And I actually used to feel ki, oh shit, ha, matlab, I was the only one in my friends, in my family to do 2-3 TikToks. But then when reels came and everything, I thought that why can't I use this interest of mine with my career, you know, to build up my business. So that's when I started with Cure Physio Reels, and that's how it's going. I think I have just made few right now, but I don't want to stop it because I really enjoy, and I really enjoy giving message into people in different ways, you know.
Right.
So I can teach them exercises, I can teach them myths and facts through reels, because nowadays that's the trend and people are just scrolling. So इससे अगर उनको कुछ information मिलता हो, या इससे किसी का, you know, कुछ ध्यान जाता है, कुछ कोई, you know, help कर सकता है किसी और को कि back pain का मैंने ये reel देखा था, उसने hot pack use किया था, तो you should try, या you know, इनको online consultation कर ले. So I think social media is trending right now, and it's like everything work from home is going on, so why not? Even I felt that we should step in.
And with the changing trends, we need to adapt to all of this, definitely.
We need to adopt. Yes.
And you deal with...
I am a fan of your reels as well, okay?
Thank you so much.
I am really a fan of your reels.
I need to learn from you.
No, it's very informative. I am actually, I think you posted some full form reels,
yes,
full form. Did
yes,
you know
yes,
the
yes.
full form of this? Trust me, I had no idea of those full forms. So I am really looking forward to your reels to know more, you know. So that's
Right,
really
right.
nice.
And after you choose a song in your reel, I adopt it in my reel as well.
I think we are going hand in hand. It's
Yes,
a teamwork.
definitely. Coming to the patients, your field definitely deals
Yes.
with a lot of people, human. So we cannot have this ego-oriented attitude with us because we have to deal with so many kinds of patients. So what do you suggest to the
Yes.
students? Ki kaise attitude rakhna chahiye when you are trying to deal with different kinds of patients? Or what are the patient viewpoints? Ki wo kaise aate hai aapke paas? Some of them are rigid, some of them are flexible, some are not ready to adapt to the trends. So unka attitude kaise hona chahiye? Dr. Kreena, I cannot see your video. Pause hua hai.
Can you see me now?
Yes, I can.
Yeah, I think there was a network issue. So I think I just like all the students to, you know, just be honest. That's it. You know, just be honest in a very polite way, because, you know, doctors are supposed to understand even the psychological level of the patients, you know, the person who is standing in front of you. Even if you know
sorry,
that
sorry
even
to
if he's
interrupt
wrong,
again.
Or if he's...
Aapka video kharab aa raha hai. Network issue aa raha hai thoda.
Okay, just let me check.
Yes.
Am I clear now?
Yes, you are.
Yeah. Yes, okay. So, shall I repeat what I wanted to say?
Yes, please.
Yeah. So, what I want to say is just be honest with the patients and in a very polite way, because as a doctor, it's very important to understand the psychological level of the person who is standing in front of you. I would not say person, rather a patient who is standing in front of you. So, you know, they are, you know, very irritated with the pain also. They just don't know what to do. Sometimes they might be wrong. Sometimes they actually don't understand. And, you know, then they might throw tantrums also. But you all should understand the situation, handle it in a very smart way and in a polite way, where you can give your, you know, give your, whatever you want to do and whatever you want to say, you can say it in a, rather in a polite way, rather than using a harsh way. That's what I would say. Yeah. Be honest.
Right. So do you remember the day when you got to know that you are now Dr. Kreena Gandhi? So wo kya feeling tha?
I think it was my graduation day, and I really remember it with my degree certificate in my hand, and I was really happy looking at it. So it was a proud moment for me and my family as well. And there are times when I feel that, okay, what more I can do? It has just motivated me. It has never let me down, and I just want to excel in this field. I don't want to stop working or serving other people right now. So I am really happy, because I always feel that I was a person who loved to care for people, and I think my service involves that. So I'm really happy. I have chosen the right profession, so I'm really happy with it.
Your care definitely shows in the friends group also. You're the most caring person always.
Yeah, thank you.
And do you plan to add up to some of your more certificates or any other courses that you're going to take up later on?
Yes, I do plan to, because I feel that many courses have come up, like kinesiotaping. There is kinesiology, exercise therapy. It's just increasing, you know. It's like sports nutrition, exercises, injury prevention. There is just, it's never ending. So I think you should never stop learning. You can always take those small courses. Now is the right time, because it's online also, it's available.
Yes.
People, pehle aisa hota tha ki ye course Delhi mein hai, Delhi tak kaun jayega, ye conference Mumbai mein hai. So right now, abhi jab sab online ho raha hai, it's very important for all the physiotherapy students also out there. If you all are skeptical, you know, don't be. Just pay the money and just learn. In the end, you're going to get certificate, and it's going to add on your experience only. So it's
definitely
good. So I am also planning to learn something. Yes, it's in my to-do list. But just once my daughter turns 1 year old, I'm just waiting for her. And once I settle everything, I'm just going to start. Yeah.
Yes, definitely. Any few motivational words for our students, like all the students right now, 10th, 12th students, koi motivational words unke liye taki haan wo utke khade ho jaye ki haan mujhe career abhi decide karna hi hai, kisme enter karna hai.
Motivational, I would just say that I think it's my, if you want to do something, you know, just stand up right now. And if you, I think there is a quote, right? If you want a change, you need to do something right now. If yes. you don't do anything, there won't be a change. It's just like that. If you want to change something, you have to, you know, work on it. Otherwise, it's no point. It's just going to be the way it is going on right now. So right. I would like to tell everyone just to stand up, think over it, what you all want to do. Spare some time. And it's not far away. It's not difficult. वो जो pressure रहता है 10th का 12th का ऐसा कुछ भी नहीं है. वो एक बार जब pass हो गया, एक बार आपने आपकी field choose कर ली, then no, there is no stopping. You are going to enjoy the ride. It's like that.
Yes, definitely. Thank you so much. Thank you for sparing your important time right now, because it is a really crucial time. And we are really sorry if we have disturbed you with your daughter, Krisa. I hope she's not woken up yet. She's sleeping.
No, not at all.
Yes.
No, she's sleeping. So I still have some me time with me.
Thank you so much.
I will definitely share your contact details. I would like to thank you for inviting me.
Thank you. Thanks a lot.
Thank you so much.